H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Now we are going to understand about this handling multiple windows. It's basically multiple browsers. Okay, so here our scenario is in this kfirst.com. First, we'll click on this providers tab. Okay, and then click on find a provider. Here, as of now, it is opening in a new separate tab. Okay, so here in this new tab, we want to click on dental. Okay, so this is the scenario. Okay, so now in general, by default, Selenium WebDriver will have the focus on this original browser itself. Now we have to bring the focus from this parent browser to its child browser. Okay, now we'll try to understand this concept. So let me then go to the kfirst website here. Now I'll writing where we write the according logic here. Now here. HTTP. kfirst.com. Okay. So once I open the browser, once I open this URL, now here I want to click on this provider's main tab. Okay. Let me find the locator of this. Now see here, we don't agree here. So here I can take this ID, okay. I can take this ID, if we have name, I don't think so we have the name. So here I can take the ID or I can depend on the link text. If you agree here, it has an ID. Okay, so we'll prefer the link text. Providers. Find element. Of course, we can take anyone, but here I'm taking link text providers. So click. Right. So I'm doing a click operation here. I'm opening the application, then I'm doing a click operation over here providers. Then it come to another page where see here we have a find a provider. Okay. Here we want to click on this find a provider. So I'm again try and find the locator. See here, it is a tag, so it is also a link. So I'm copying the link text here. Okay, so once we click on this find a provider, we are getting into another page. Say here I want to click on this dental. Okay, so let me copy of this. Now can you agree here? This dental, if you observe this, it is bounded with A tag, but within the A tag there is span. We'll see. So I'm saying dental. So let me try to take a link. Say a link dental. If you observe that, you know it is getting highlighted that particular part. The dental is, that particular section is getting highlighted in green color. Okay, probably if you want to make sure, yeah, basically you can say click and wait, and let me double click on this thing. Yep, it seems it is working. Okay, so now here, I think I can directly take this dental. This one. Now see here, our browser, find element by, again I am taking as link text, dental is the value, that click. In general we would have write the logic like this, right? Like here, first, here in the first browser, you clicked on the this provider main menu. Okay, we in the previous page we clicked on the provider, and then here we clicked on the find a provider. Here we clicked on find a provider. Once we click on find a provider, we are getting into this browser. So actually here, if you observe here in the logic, as of now I did not consider it. When we click a find a provider, a new browser is opening. A new browser or a tab is going to open. It's just a configuration in the browser. Okay, a new browser is opening a tab. Both are same here. Okay, so here first we are clicking on providers, and then we are clicking find a provider, and we are getting into a new browser. Here in new browser we are clicking on dental. In general, with the knowledge that we have so far, we would have write the logic like this. We'll try to execute this. Okay, now we will try to execute this. This should fail at the this last line. Okay, now see here. Now here it is clicked on providers. Now observe here, it has opened a new browser. Okay, now here if you observe here in this new browser, it did not click on dental over here. Okay, and it is still said pause. Any guesses why it is said pause? Actually expectation is it should fail, but any guesses why it it got passed. Any guesses? Yep. See here. No. If you observe here in the let me show both the windows first. See here. This was our browser window, right? If you observe here, this is a web driver. Okay. This was the window that we have opened earlier. It seems there is a dental in the original window also. Are you getting what I'm saying? If you observe here, it is showing a dental screen here. So it seems there is a dental link in the original window also. So instead of, however, our expectation was it wanted to click on this dental over here, right? It did not click dental here in the child window. Okay, this is a child window. I mean child window in the sense the it is opened by the this program. Okay, now see this is a web driver here. This is a web driver. Okay. So our expectation was it has to click on dental, but it did not leave dental over here. It clicked dental in the parent window itself. It means the focus was not getting into this page. Okay. The focus is not getting into this page. Okay. Probably, you know, instead of that, probably we'll see if we have any other option. Say for example, vision. Probably here also we might have vision. We'll see. How to use the online directory, something like that. We will see if we have that or no. Here, what I'm saying here, we'll capture this. Okay, I'm capturing this text here. Okay, now here we'll try to find. We'll try to use over here in this browser, in this page. We'll see whether it is there or not. Yep, see here it is saying in this browser, in this parent one, it is saying it is not there. Okay, now if we go to the child one, now we'll try to highlight here. Now see here it is getting highlighted. So probably we'll use this so that we can find the difference. Okay, so here I'm removing with the dental with this how to use the online directory, because this is there in the child window, it is not there in the parent window. Okay, now see here we'll try to execute this. Meanwhile, let me close these two. So now it has to open the main window. From the main window, here in this main window, it has to click on provider. Now it has to click on providers tab. Yep, here it has clicked on providers. Then it has to click on find a provider. Now see here, it has opened a new browser. Okay, it has opened a new browser. Now if you all observe here, it is showing an error here, right? And the server should be like no such element for exception, no such element exception, unable to locate the method, unable to locate the element, this one. It means this is the how to use the online directory. This is not there in the parent here. It is not there in the parent. So that is the reason it is throwing an error. It means it did not change the focus from the old window to the new window. Okay. So now here we have a concept. By using that concept, we can change the Selenium WebDriver focus from the old window to the new window. Okay. Now here, everyone observe here. So when we click on this find a provider, then only we are getting a new browser, right? Okay, when we click on this find a provider, then we are getting into a new window. So for that case, now if you observe here, so before clicking on a find a provider, first let me explain the logic here, what is the logic that I am going to write. Okay, then it would be easy for you to understand. See here, say first, just for example, here in this example itself, in the carefirst.com, okay, first we click on provider, and then we will click on find a provider. So when we click on this find a provider, then it is opening a new browser. It is opening a new browser. And then here we were trying to click on how to. What is that text? How to use the online directory. Okay. So here, basically what is happening, these three are related to the first window. I mean, say browser one. And here this is related to browser 2. Browser 1. And this is related to browser 2. Okay. So by default, as you understood, here Selenium will have the focus on the browser 1 only. Okay. It will not change the focus from browser 1 to browser 2. So to change the focus, here what I'm trying to do here, everyone agree here, before we click on a find a provider, before we click on find a provider, here I will get the this browser one related information here. Okay, get the browser one info. Okay, first I will save this browser one info here. Okay, so in this browser one, here in this section, so before I clicking on find a provider, here I will get the browser one information here. Okay, here I will get the browser one information. Now once we click on, once we have the new browser here, it means we have the old browser as well as new browser, right? Here what I will do here, okay, here I will get all the browsers information, get all the browsers information here. Okay, so here first it will get the browser one information here. Okay, here browser one means Selenium WebDriver browser. Okay, it will get this browser information, and here it will get the previous browser information as well as the new browser information. Okay, and here we know that when we click on a find a provider, we are getting only one browser. Okay, so here however, here we'll get one browser information, and here we'll get all the browser informations. So here I will exclude this browser one information over here, so that the remaining is nothing but the new browser information, right? Are you getting? Say here, this browser one information is like, say, B123. Okay, say the first browser information is like, say it has an ID, B123. And here when I say get all the browser information, probably it will give B123, comma, B say some 456. Now here in this information, if I exclude B123, remaining one is nothing but the new browser, right? Are you able to follow this concept? Any questions here? See here, the first browser information, I will get this first browser information. Say that information is B123. And once we get the new browser, here I will write a logic to get all the browser's information. Okay, so it is going to retrieve all the browser's information, means it is going to retrieve the old browser information. It is also get the new browser information. Okay, here it will be like B123, B456. Then here we will write a logic, exclude the browser one info in the above information. So which is nothing but we are trying to point out to the new browser, right? Are you able to follow this? Any questions here? Is it clear? Is this clear? Any questions here? Say yes or no. Yep. If you have any questions, please point out over here. Please mention over here. Okay. Yep. Great. Now we'll write the logic here. So now actually we are going to, now we have a logic to open this browser. We have a logic to open this, clicking on this provider, find a provider. I know here we have a logic to how to use this. Now the thing is, now we have to write a logic to include this, include these two lines. Okay. Now see here. So before I click on find a provider, here I'm getting the get the browser one information here. Okay. Now see here how to get the browser information means. Here, O browser. There is something called get window handle. Now if you observe here, there is something called get window handle. It basically it retrieves the browser information here. Okay. Get window handle means it is going to retrieve the browser information. So let me save it in a variable here, and it is going to return a string. And how I know whether it is going to return a string or not? How did I know about? Now when you use this, if you observe here, it is saying that it is string. It means the output of this particular get window will be string. Okay, that is the reason I'm capturing the value into string here. Okay, so get window handle. So I'm trying to capture this output into a string, and let me say O parent. Okay, O parent brw. Okay, so this is the line which is going to retrieve the information of the parent window, and it is going to save in this variable. Okay, now here once we click on find a provider, we know that there are multiple browsers. So now here Abdul here again O browser, and here basically now what I'm trying to do here, get all the browsers information here. Okay, now observe here, O browser, there is get window. Now if you observe here, there is get window handles. There is a small difference, right? Get window handle, get window handles. When we say get window handles, it is going to retrieve the all the browsers information. Okay. Now if you observe here, it is saying set string. So now here also we have to write it in the same way. Okay. Now as it is saying set string, so it means basically it is an array of strings. Okay. Now here let me say all browsers. Okay, now here this should be Java util. Okay, just import this related information, this one. Now here, so here we are going to have all the browsers information here, and here we are having the parent browser information. Now here we are going to exclude the parent information over here. Okay. Now here we have to write a logic, exclude the browser one information here in the above, in the above information. Okay, we have to exclude this information in this information. Now see here, we know this is all browsers is going, it is an array which contains the browsers information. Now everyone up there, here I am writing a for loop. And did you remember this syntax? This I explained here in a group of elements. Here you know, this is like an array, and here I'm writing this for loop. I'm iterating this for loop based on the number of values in this array. If this array contains 20, this for loop is going to be iterated for 20 times. If it contains 2, this for loop is going to be iterated for 2 times. Okay. Now each time here, when I say OH browser, each time this OH browser value will change from one value to the other value. Okay. For the first time, for the first iteration, it is going to point to the first value first. For the first time it is going to point to the first value, for the second time it is going to point to the second one. Okay, Now see here, give a minute, yep. Now Audrey here, I'm trying to get here, I think we can directly see Audrey here. So this information should not equal to this information, right? I mean, if excluding means in this information, if this information is not equal to this information, it is nothing but the information that it is containing is nothing but a new browser, right? Okay, let me complete the logic here. Otherwise, let me say like this. These are the strings, right? It's here. Matches. Okay. I'm saying matches, or even I can use contains. If you remember, we discussed this contains. Okay. And here, if this contains this one, not even contains, we'll see if we have any equals. Remember, there is a method called equals. Okay, if this is equals to this one, parent browser. Okay, now here basically we want a value which should not equal. Okay, which should not be equal. Okay, because if it is equals, again it is pointing to the old window, right? The parent window and this information is both are equal. The variable it contains the old window. Okay, basically we want to have a new window, right? So for this, see here that we have to mention not equal. Not equal means the symbol here in Java, like this. We have to mention this one. Okay, whenever this condition satisfies, here I am saying exit, not exit. Here in VB script it is break. Okay, when I said break, so whenever this condition satisfies, it will exit this for loop. What does it mean? Say here in this array we have 20 values. Okay, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that, say 1 to 20. Okay, say if this value is 5, at that time, I'm looking for the value 5. Okay, if this value equals to 5, I will say break. So once, as we are trying to find the value 5, as it is there, I can exit this for loop. I don't want to continue with the execution. So here I can say break here, simple. Okay, now here itself I can write a logic. See here, o browser dot. O browser dot switch to. Okay, by mentioning switch to, okay, what is that? A window. Okay, here we have to give this value. Okay, so this is how it changes the focus from the old window to the new window. So if it is not equal, mean it is going to ignore the. It is going to exclude the parent window here. Okay, it means whenever we have a value other than the parent window, it will get into this if loop, and here the focus will be changed to the new window, and it will exit this for loop because it been achieved. Okay, now we'll try to execute this logic here. Before that, let me close these browsers. So this is like breaking down the logic. First we got the browser one information, And secondly, after we have multiple windows, we retrieve the, all the browser's information. Then we have excluded the browser one information in the all the browser's information. Now it has to click on providers here. Then it has to click on find a provider. Then it is opening a new browser. Now here our expectation is it has to click on how to use the online directory here. Okay. Did you observe that? It clicked on how to use the online directory now. Now if you observe here, it is saying it clicked on how to use the online directory here. Okay. Now here if you observe here, it is a green color bar. Okay. So now here one more thing is here we have a perception that when we click on this find a provider, we know that here it is opening only one other browser. It means here we are having a perception that two browsers. Okay. One is the parent one and the other is the child one. Okay, this logic is built on based on perception that there will be two browsers. So for example, when you click on a find a provider, say it is opened a multiple browsers. I mean to say we have a parent window, say parent browser one. Okay, so once you click on find a provider, just assume it is opened some three other browsers. Okay, say it has opened three other browsers. Okay, this logic, whatever the logic that we have written, what will happen, it will choose any one of these three browsers. Okay, it will choose among any one of this any one of the three new browsers. Okay, the logic that we have written here, first it will exclude this parent one, but it is going to choose any one of the three browsers which is open. Okay, now here if you want to open a particular window, okay, say you clicked on this find a provider, say it has opened, for example, it has opened, let me say ABCD website, okay, some, otherwise let me say, for example, just it has opened, say eBay website, say Amazon website, okay, and then say some other deals to buy website, or say Costco website, okay. Say when you click on this parent one, okay, say for example it has opened eBay.com, Amazon, Costco, it is single click, okay, in the parent one, if you click on this find a provider, okay, say in the parent one, if you click on find a provider, say it has opened these three browsers, and whatever the logic that we have written, it may choose any one of these three. We are not sure what it is going to choose. Here we know that once we click on find a provider, it has opened only one other browser. That is the reason we can write this logic. But here in this case, when you click on find a provider, it is opening three windows. Okay, among these three windows, it may choose any one window. If you want to choose a particular window, here you have to give the browser title here. Whatever the title, whatever the browser that you want to choose here, here instead of writing this excluding, instead of writing all these things, you can directly mention here in this switch to window, here you can give the title of the browser. But you know, in general, you know, out of 100 scenarios, I can say 99 scenarios will be like this. Okay, there are very very peculiar cases where when you click one link, it will open multiple browsers. There are only very peculiar cases. Okay, in general we will not come across those things. If you come across, at that time directly mention browser.switch to window of, here mention the title of the window. Okay, that's it. This is how we handle the multiple browsers here. Okay, now let me go to the next topic here. Handling Ajax auto suggestions actually I thought to remove this, but it has been there in the session. Let it. Here, what is this means? Yep, give me a minute. Let me log out from my Gmail account here. Give me a minute. Now everyone agree here, I come across a Gmail page here, okay, Gmail some sign in page, okay, probably let me open Gmail here, okay, say once we open Gmail, okay, say once we open Gmail here, say I want to click on create an account, okay, then after that if you agree here auto suggestions means, here when you enter some value here, can you observe here, when we enter some value here and immediately it is showing some value here, right, strong, it is giving kind of feedback here, it is saying too short, right, so handling auto suggestions means these are the auto suggestions, okay, and basically this concept, why we are mentioning here, it's the same way, the way that we are going to discuss, it's whatever we have been discussing, the way it is also the same way, but here we exclusively mentioned just to give a preference to it, okay, one thing. The other way is, if you try to automate these kind of scenarios in QTP, it will be a bit difficult, okay, in QTP it will not work as Selenium works over here, okay. QTP don't have that much capacity in getting this this status immediately. Okay, QTP could not probably it will not handle this kind of things, but efficient way. Okay, however, excuse me. Okay, here basically whatever we enter here, it is giving the accordingly feedback here. Okay, said good. Like strong, okay. Now we'll try to automate this, and we'll try to get this this value. Okay, we'll try to retrieve this value here. Okay. So first we'll write a logic to open the Gmail. Once our browser dot get http www.gmail.com, and here we are getting a create an account, so let me find the locator of this. So it is an ID, or even we can depend on this create an icon. Yep. Now see here, it has some spaces. Can you all agree here? Create an icon which contains some spaces. In this case, link text is may not be the preferable option here. Okay. So let me take this ID. Okay. So here I'm taking the ID of browser. Find element. by ID. Or I know the other way. Okay, I think I did not explain about here. Now here observer, here create an account which contains spaces. But however, let me show there is one more option. Okay. Here there is something like can you observe partial link text? Can you observe that? Partial link text means you can basically give the a part of it. Okay. So we'll try to use this, we'll see whether it is going to work or not. Okay, why I was not preferring this this link text. Before and after we have some spaces. Okay. So here there is something called partial link text which is available over here. It means you can give a part of it. Okay, we'll give it a try with this. Now here, 1 minute. Okay, we are clicking on this create an account. And then here, here in this password field, when we enter any value, it is giving a feedback. Okay, so here we have ID. So I'm entering some value here. Go browser, find element by ID and send keys. Okay, before that, let us clear it. Let me here mention some ABCD. Okay, I'm mentioning ABCD here. And before that, let me clear to be in safer site. Okay. So here I've entered ABCD. Here I'm going to enter ABCD. So here we will get a feedback here. I want to retrieve this information here. So now let us find the locator of this. So right click, inspect element with firebug. Now if you observe here, it has an ID. Okay, password rating. So we'll try to take this ID. Go browser, find element. And by ID, okay. And did we discuss about this point, how to retrieve a value from an object? And here actually I want to retrieve this two shot here. Did we discuss about this? I think somewhere we discussed get text, right? By using get text, see here, this by using this object we can refer this particular two shot. Okay. Now I want to get the text of it. So here there is a method called getText. However, even we discussed or even we don't discuss, we will discuss this topic as part of verification. In the maybe probably in the next session. Okay. Here as part of verification we will understand it. Okay. So here basically getText means it is going to retrieve this text from the application. This two shot will be retrieved from the application here. Okay. So here let me capture into a variable. String s text. Okay, so here now let me print it. Okay, now you try to execute this. Now see here, if you observe here, it is clicked on create icon. Now observe here, it has entered password ABCD and we got the feedback two shot. Now that has to be print over here. Now can you observe here, two shot has been printed here. Okay. Basically this, it's the normal way, whatever the way that we are writing here. If you observe here, we did not consider anything special. Okay. But however, you know, why we have mentioned here, you know, this is how to handle, you know, these are some kind of auto suggestions, okay. And moreover, in QTP, the same concept will be a bit tricky to handle, okay.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.